Last night, didn't I? I didn't think it was going to happen.
Just over a year. Which is actually quite normal, really.
It has, their relationship has been a bit of a slow burner, really, from the beginning, hasn't it? We weren't quite sure whether it was going to come together or not.
Yeah, and, you know, there's insecurities on Dom's part as well, because the previous relationships he's had, not great relationships. And then Lofty, being quite a sensitive soul as well, was not quite ready to make that leap. Mm. And then, obviously, the twist last night was they both proposed to each other.
Yeah. Yes, simultaneously. And you talk about the sensitive side of Lofty, and we saw that when he sort of took on board Dom's mum last night, Carol, who did make me laugh.
Yeah,
because she was sort of questioning whether you should go ahead with the proposal, and it wasn't exactly what you needed to hear.
Well, he calls her into the hospital, he asks her to come to the hospital, because they're so busy doing their 14-hour shifts, as you do as a nurse, and then asking for Dom's hand in marriage, and she's actually, I don't think he's a marrying type. And
No one wants to hear that when you're asking.
That's like great.
And obviously you were doing chitty chitty bang bang and all sorts of things in that time. But then to come back again to the role, it must have been quite nice to pick up where you left off.
It was great. I never thought it was going to happen. I did 2 years, and my little girl Betsy was 4 or 5 at the time, and we're filming down in Cardiff, and I was just back at weekends, which was fine. But after 2 years, I was really missing the school runs and the school pickup. Yeah. So they asked me to stay on, which was lovely, but I thought I need to be at home. And so I took 3 months off with Betsy, my little one, and then toured with Chitty, flying the car, like cracked his pots around the country for 5 months. And then they asked me to come back into Holby, which is great, because I live in Southend, so I can commute from Mill Street every day.
Yes,
of course. Weekends off to do my concerts and my gigs, and then, so I'm very lucky,
How old's Betsy now?
She's 8.
She's 8, isn't she?
Yeah, she turned 8 in May, so
is she sort of old enough now to you know, recognise that you're the performer? You get up and, like, Daddy is the singer as well, does she?
Yeah, she sees me in Panto every year, but I'm hoping she's going to catch my new tour, because I had a young chap, he was just turned 7, and my last gigs came with his mum and dad. I thought, well, Betsy's 8 now, so maybe she could come and see me in concert for the first time as well.
Of course.
It's a 2-hour show and about 17, 18 songs, so she might be a bit bored at halfway through.
No,
I don't know.
It's Danny, of course.
It's like, here he goes again, singing. Yeah. I guess, like any couple, really, when your kid's your priority, and you want them to be happy and safe, you just do everything you can to make sure that's, she's happy, and, you know,
life has carried on really quite comfortably.
I was single for quite a while, but with a lovely girl called Izzy now. We've been together 7.5 years, it's nice to found someone again, and just, you know, like anyone, sort of share your time together. And she's got a lovely little boy called Alfie as well.
That works, doesn't it?
He's got 5, yeah.
So. Yeah, no, that's lovely. And, like, you always say about going back to any dream we'll do, it's over 10 years ago now, obviously.
Blimey, yeah.
But on all levels, actually, and you're very proud of that moment.
Yeah, I think those that know me, I'm just, you know, the same person, and normal lad from Southend, but you're suddenly meeting Tom Jones, and you perform at Wembley to 70-odd thousand people, and then you're on Jonathan Ross show, and you're making albums, and It's really weird.
Yeah,
you've gone from being the chorus of a show to then all these things happening. But it was a wonderful time, and I just feel lucky. You know, 10 years on, that's part of this tour that I'm doing, the celebration of the last 10 years, and to put an album together and just talk about the last 10 years, really. And
To still do that music that you love.
Yeah, I'm just pleased I'm still working.
It's great. You've still got the coat as well, haven't you?
I've got it out for the first time on this tour. So
I'm
taking it on the theatres, so it still fits. Like,
that's good. No, it's great to see you, Lee. We will be watching Holby, see what happens.
Thanks for it. Yeah, tune in. Keep watching.
We will indeed. Thank you very much.